guys hoist it.
Yeah.
Do a dunk.
Can you believe back in the olden days that trophy cutthroat anglers, if they hooked a bull trout, they would just toss it on the banks as like a garbage fish to die because they would decimate the cutthroat population. And here we are in 2023. I'm going to have to say that bull trout are one of the most sought after species to target. It's just crazy how times have changed. Why am I a charaholic? Good question. Why am I not, I guess? You know, what's not cool about, you know, a native species that's only native to Western or North America, like the Western states and Western Canada. They're big, predatorial, migratory fish that travel long distances that will eat like a whitefish off the end of your line or inhale a 12-inch streamer right at your feet. But I'm gonna have to say the most thing I love about bull trout is, you know, the demographic of it. They basically live in heaven's nectar. Where you're looking around, your surroundings, the mountains, the glacial blue waters, it's really surreal. You don't even really have to catch a fish sometimes. Like, it's so beautiful. It's so addicting.
Boys!
Yeah!
We did it!
What are you going for today? Bear spray and 40-inch bull trout.
Yeah, it's kind of actually random how I met Max and we became friends. About a year ago, I was looking for a place to go shoot some film and market skins in the salt. And I came across a destination, Isla Holbosch. And I was just looking through hashtags, see Max just holding a snook. So I kind of messaged him and asked him if he wanted to take me fishing. And it happened that he actually ran a guiding service down there. And not only that, that he has actually been to filming school. So it was kind of a hit out of the park. So he brought me into his world there, and I wanted to return the favor, bring him into the whole, you know, char scene out west. So he booked his flight, landed, and I decided to take him to a local river that I knew about where there was some bull trout right away to get him on the board.
You already know what it is, boy.
Max from Vermont.
Morning.
Skinned up.
Let's go.
Left.
Sheesh. You have far peak. Holy shit.
Slay.
Cheers, buddy. First bull, Alberta.
Let's
go.
Myself, I originally come from trout and freshwater kind of background, and just seeing you guys catch these fish just kind of, it seemed to me like the pinnacle of trout fishing and freshwater fishing. It just looks like an ultimate adventure, so I was like, I gotta experience it for myself and come out and do it. So that's kind of what brought me out here.
Out here in the Canadian Rockies, catching some big bulls. It's a beautiful experience out here. I just love it, man. Got some nice hogs this morning and it was a lot of fun, man.
There is something incredibly gratifying about introducing a friend to a new species and taking them to a place they have never experienced. After successfully landing a couple of bulls on a local Alberta river, we decided it was time for an epic deep backcountry adventure. This meant exploring a river that I'd always wanted to visit, but I've never been to before. We made our way into the interior of British Columbia and met up with my close friend Alex, who had fished this river before and claimed to have a great starting point for us.
Okay, yeah, just follow me up there.
Kelly, right. Needed a place to go where there was some legendary bull trout, and I knew of a spot. I knew we'd hit the water, and he invited his friend along, Max, and we headed up to the backcountry, Sherpa mode, and caught some tanks.
This is the first hole.
It's still day one, and we finally arrived at camp after a long, grueling journey on a backcountry road. It was getting late, and after enjoying a few mountain pops, we were pondering whether it was worth walking down to the river to begin deciphering its hidden secrets. Naturally, our anticipation grew too strong. Then there's Max, the Jedi Knight that he is. It didn't take him too long before he picked the fight with a bull and was battling it down the river.
What? Oh, really?
Oh my God.
Gotta get some movement in, you know, like go like this.
Oh yeah, dude, like sit there and yeah.
Well, Max. Day two. What's your thoughts on Canada and chasing bull trout?
200 kilometers into the backcountry, finding these like migratory giants. It's like insane, absolutely insane.
It's awesome.
In the headwaters, the upper Rockies, one of a kind.
Ready to go? He's like, I need a bull trout.
Today's the day we catch 30.
Catch 30, I'll be happy with a 25.
All right, here goes the journey, boys. You got
the top one.
Is it deep?
Skins, baby.
With Max catching that bull trout the night prior, things were looking pretty promising on day two. However, the next morning was filled with constant river crossings and long stretches of water casting. Yet not even a single chase. It appeared that bull trout from last night might have been just passing through, and we got lucky. Our confidence started to diminish rapidly. I pulled out my maps and showed Max the location where I thought they could possibly be, and he agreed. During this time of year, bulls are always on the move, whether alone or in pairs, so it's just a matter of finding them.
Look at that thing! Hey, go! You gotta run down river!
Max has Hawkeyes. He would find them, like, you know, one by himself, just under a log jam or something. Alex and I would just walk by. I think by like day two, he was the one guiding us in the bull trout.
We called him Laser Vision. He saw every bull trout that we pretty much got into and couldn't have done it without him.
Just seeing these bulls in their native habitat is just insane. So you're seeing them in all different types of areas. You're seeing them in deep holes, you're seeing them under structure, and then sometimes they're even in that open back end of the pool sitting in the sun. We approached the fish all different types of ways, but there was this one fish that really just stuck with me for the trip, and he was sitting in the further back end of the pool. You could see him just so clear, and I told you, I was like, I'm gonna sight fish this fish right now, and so
that was an awesome sight fish.
You can see the fish really well, you got plenty of room to cast, and you put the fly upstream. And sometimes they don't strike it on the first try. I mean, these fish are like, they're so predatorial in their holes. They control everything in their hole. So you put a fly in there and sometimes they'll just push it out. They'll just give it a bite as if like, get out of my hole. And then sometimes they're like, I'm hungry, I'm gonna eat this. So you give them a few casts, a few tries, and eventually he's gonna eat that fly. They just smash it. So aggressive. I love it.
I'm talking closer to that log. Oh!
What do you think, Kelly?
Man, it's awesome. Beautiful place. Heaven's Nectar with a bunch of good buddies. Lost in the backcountry. Good times, man. I don't think anything beats this. Sherpa mode.
I love fly fishing because it gets you out in the mountains. You go places that no one's ever been before, and you're exploring. And that's the whole part of fly fishing that I like the most, is that you're exploring new places, and you might be the first person to ever step foot in that spot.
The main goal of the trip was to target these big bull trout. That's what we wanted. We just came out to find the big fish. And you backcountry boys have been on them for a few years, so you know kind of where they are and where they like to hang out. Yeah, a lot of times you go on a trip and you just focus on the fishing so much, and that's really what it's all about, obviously. Like, we all just want to get in the zone and fish. But reliving the memories, we mentioned that, you know, seeing what you went through in a film a year later, 2 years later, showing friends and family the experience. That's just something you can't like get back out of just memories in your head.
Like, I mean, what a trip, right? Just to be out there, like with today's distractions in the world, it's just so nice to be out there in the present moment, sharing memories with these guys. That's like what fishing's really been all about for me for a long time. It's just, you know, being out there in the backcountry, having no reception, just a place where you can kind of let loose a bit, just get lost in, you know, the abyss of the forest and the rivers. It's just truly a treat. I just can't wait to get back out there.